Welcome back. Well, Eastern Idaho has a new weapon in training for spring sports, specifically softball and baseball. I stopped by the sand lot to see how our area teams are using this facility to advance the sport on this side of the state.
If you build it, they will come. That's the idea behind the sand lot in Pocatello, and just a few months into its existence, it's already paying off. ISU's club baseball team has traded their old practice facility, Cotant Park, for this indoor training area that is the envy of teams from throughout the West.
Spoke with numerous other team players, other programs, and some of them have come here to play ball with us here at ISU that have played at some of the JUCOs, NAIA, Division I colleges that they've played in. And the indoor facilities are almost non-existent at this level. This facility provides so much more opportunity than many of the other places that you attend school at, and it gives them that sharp, it gives them a better opportunity to get sharper earlier in the season.
ISU's club baseball team isn't the only team using this facility. You can also find the Bengals softball team in there on a regular basis. The Sandlot has even worked out deals with several of our area high school teams, and that should benefit the sport here in Eastern Idaho. As for ISU's club team, well, they're looking to take advantage of anything they can get as they play in one of the toughest leagues in the country. Coach believes that the Sandlot just might be the answer towards getting the Bengals over that hump and making a run in the national tournament.
Cotant was a great place when the weather's nice, but this time of year, obviously, we can't get outside and do the kind of practices, the kind of field work, batting practices that we need to do. And so having this sandlot facility and Mike Wise and his family making this feasible for ISU has made it a great bonus, as well as for all the other high schools and community to come in here and be able to get all the batting you want, pitching, fielding. It's just a fantastic opportunity for us to compete, especially when we're playing schools from California, Arizona, Nevada, some of those warmer climates where they have year-round access to playing outside and not having to deal with the adverse weather conditions that we deal with here in southeastern Idaho.
And, of course, the Sandlot is open to the public. You don't have to be an athlete to go there. That's going to do it for us. The DeLorean is gassed up. We're about to hit 88 miles per hour. We'll leave you now with some old-school 80s hoops. We'll see you next week.